begin to bless the name of the Lord this evening. Begin to worship his name. I'm going to quickly read 2 Samuel 22 verse 3 says, For who is God except the Lord? Who but our God is a solid rock? God is my strong fortress. So you're going to declare tonight, you're going to bless the name of the Lord tonight because it's your solid rock. Just begin to worship his name tonight because you even connected to him. It's by grace that we're being called a child of God. Let's bless his name this evening. Just open your heart and begin to worship his holy name. Just forget about your sorrows, forget about your troubles, forget about your situation and just begin to reach out to God tonight. Begin to worship him. Father, you are my solid rock. I thank you for the things that you do in my life. I thank you for the battles that you fight for me. You're so faithful. You're so awesome. Even when I'm not faithful, you're forever faithful unto me. I love you, Lord. Begin to declare your love to him. I love you. I love you, Lord. You are my God. You are my fortress. You are my strength. You are so perfect in all your ways. Daddy, I salute your holy name. I bless you. Bless God for the grace given unto you to see August. Oh, Masato Bashadada. Bless his name this evening. Just bless his name this evening. I don't know what is pulling you back, but I just want you to run to the Lord tonight and begin to worship him. That we bless your name. We bless your name. For in Jesus' mighty name, we have worshiped. Amen. God is so awesome. God is so awesome. There's no doubt about it. If you know what God is doing for you, even when you know nothing about, if God decides to open your spiritual eyes to see the battles he fights for you, to see the doors he's opening for you, to see how he's pushing back the forces of darkness, you can't just but bless his name. Every plan of the devil, the Lord has said, no way, is not your portion. In the name of Jesus, you are alive today. I don't know what you're thinking about. I don't know what your problems are, but you are alive today because of the grace of God. And we ought to honor him. God is so good. God is so good. It's a month of transformation. You know, this is a kind of month that we're going to experience God in a new dimension. It's going to be so unique in the name of Jesus. Yesterday we talked about the upper room experience. We prayed about, you know, we prayed about God filling us afresh. We prayed about God getting us endued. And we know that we are endued. This moment we're just praying for God's power. Just pray for God to fill us afresh in the name of Jesus. And I know tonight, newness is coming in the name of Jesus. You know, the scripture says something profound. It says the anointing of yesterday is not enough for today. I'm praying for new anointing. I'm praying for fresh anointing. I'm praying that you get endued in the name of Jesus. Amen. You're getting endued in the name of Jesus. Please open your Bibles to the book of Acts 1 verse 8. Acts 1 verse 8, it said, but you shall receive power. Hey, what I want to talk to you about tonight is experience the power of God. It says, but you shall receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you. Oh, glory to God. You're experiencing power tonight. You're receiving power tonight because Holy Spirit is so coming upon you in the name of Jesus. And you shall be witness to me in Jerusalem, in all Judea and Samaria, and to the end of the earth. God wants to empower you just for his sake. You know, when people see you, even when the enemies see you, there will be, you know, a situation whereby your enemy becomes your friend because you're so powerful. You know, a situation whereby your enemy runs to you for help because the power of God is so fresh in you. This is the kind of power you're about to encounter tonight in the name of Jesus. The word power in Greek means dunamis. It means inherited power. Because you are a child of God, because our God is so all powerful, then you are powerful. God created us for his own sake. We are representative of God. We're here to just like exhibit his work. People can't see God, so they can't really believe God. But when they begin to see the power, I mean, the transforming power of God upon you, they can't just help but to believe God. They can't just help but to believe how glorious our God is. The power that reproduces itself. This is the kind of power you're going to get baptized with today in the name of Jesus. You know what? Tonight, the burden in your heart, but God the saying, I'm so baptizing you afresh with Holy Ghost tonight in the name of Jesus. And we're going to go everywhere doing good. We're going to go everywhere representing God in the name of Jesus. Tonight, you're going to be endued with the power of God. You're going to be a confirmation of God's power. You're going to be a true child of the Most High God. You know, it's like a fallacy, because our God is powerful and then we are children of God, then we are not powerful. It doesn't really make sense, isn't it? That's not the way it ought to be. That's not the way God wants it to be. God wants to endue us in the name of Jesus. So tonight you're going to repeat after me. Tonight you're going to say, I receive power in the name of Jesus. I receive power. Where you are, begin to declare it. I'm going to go around doing good. I receive the power of God in the name of Jesus. My God is all powerful. I'm powerful. The scripture says, it says, ye are gods. We are gods here on earth. We must represent our Father. You know, many other times we just go to God, we ask for stuff, we ask for favor, we ask for blessing. You know, having blessing without having power of God is like having nothing. Our foundation is that power. And this month, we're going to experience the newness of God in every area of our lives in the name of Jesus. Begin to say, thank you, Jesus, where you are right now. Just begin. I just want you to be lost in the spirit tonight. I really want you to have this great connection with God. You've got to be connected to get in deals with this power. You've got to be connected to be, you know, to receive the Holy Spirit tonight. Just begin to say, thank you, Jesus. Be lost in His presence. Oh, shada da 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 da. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Begin to just see God. Yesterday we put ourselves in the hands of God. And where you are tonight, and you know, David said, I want to fall in the hands of God. I don't want to fall in the hands of man. I want you to fall into the hands of God tonight. Just begin to imagine it. Begin to see yourself in the hands of the Most High God. Begin to imagine you looking into His eyes and you saying, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. From the bottom of my heart, I'm saying thank you to you. Thank you, Holy Ghost. For in Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Psalm 62, verse 11. Psalm 62, verse 11. It says, once God has spoken, two eyes have I heard. That power belongs to God. I don't know where you're seeking power. I don't know your situation and you're thinking you can't actually get help from God because you've been praying and nothing is happening. But I'm saying to you tonight that all power belongs to God. Every other thing that looks like power, they're not actually power. Every power belongs to God. And there's nothing happening to you that God can't fix. It's just because you don't actually know God, and you can't know God if you don't have His power in you. If you don't have a part of God in you, there's no how we can actually know God. So this is why we're going to declare tonight. We're going to declare, I swim in the pool of His power in the name of Jesus. I have touched myself with the Lord. I'm a child of the Most High God. I swim in the pool of His power in the name of Jesus. This is my time to experience the unforgettable. This is my time to have this unique encounter with the King of Kings. In the name of Jesus, my life will never remain the same. Never, ever, ever. My life is being transformed tonight. Oh, Masoto Basha, da 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 da. I put upon myself the power of the Holy Ghost. I have divine encounter tonight. Just begin to declare loud and clear Let the devil begin to hear him. That's why you saw yesterday, devil is not the same as that's why you're seeing today. I'm a transformed being in the name of Jesus. I saw swim in his power. This is a new day for me. It's a new moment for me. The power of God is upon me. I'm so powerful. I'm so powerful. Thank you, Jesus. For in Jesus' mighty name we've prayed, amen. 2 Corinthians 6 verse 14. 1 Corinthians 6 verse 14. It says, and God raised the Lord, and he also raised up by his power. God is so good. If you say to me, Adassa, there are some things the Lord cannot do, or there are some things happening, the Lord just choose not to do it. There's nothing God cannot do. There's nothing. There's no wall that God cannot pull down. There's no chapel the Lord cannot break. There's no door the Lord can't bust open. There's nothing God can do. It might be so impossible with man, but with God, all things are possible. It says what? He raised the Lord Jesus Christ from the dead. You know, the grave couldn't actually hold him down, because what? Is God encounter with the power of the Most High God. So tonight you're going to declare. I don't know what you're going through right now. I don't know, maybe you're feeling, you're thinking it is so over. I'm saying to you, you're coming back in the name of Jesus. The resurrection power of the Lord is upon you tonight. So you're going to declare tonight, I'm rising up from rejection in the name of Jesus. I'm rising up from heartbroken in the name of Jesus. I'm coming up. I'm coming back from addiction, from death, from sickness, from bitterness in the name of Jesus. I don't know your situation, just put your situation. I'm coming back. I'm rising up. The power of God is upon me. Death, you can't just hold me back. You can't hold me down. You've got no power over me, because I'm the child of the Most High God. I am endued with the power of God. I'm a different being. I'm an anointed being in the name of Jesus. Negativity, you have no place in my life. Negativity, you have no place in my family. In the name of Jesus, begin to declare tonight, the power of God is bringing you back. The power of God is bringing you back in the name of Jesus. The power of God is bringing you back in the name of Jesus. Begin to speak it tonight. Declare tonight. The powerful hand of God is upon me. The powerful hand of God is upon my ministry. Begin to declare it tonight. I'm resting powerfully on you, Lord. I'm not resting on any man. I'm not resting on any other thing. I'm not resting on any other power. I'm resting powerfully on you tonight. Oh, Masato Basha, da, 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 da. There's a shift happening right here in the name of Jesus. Things are shifting. Oh, Masata Kasha, da, da. I'm not an ordinary being no more. The supernatural power of God is upon me. It's resting on me. It's resting on me. It's coming up from my inside and it's radiating on the outside in the name of Jesus. Wow. This is a great encounter here tonight. This is a great encounter here tonight. Things will never remain the same. Things will never look the same in the name of Jesus. This is a new being. This is a new me. The power of God is resting upon us here tonight. The power of God is resting upon us here tonight. He says, we are two or more are gathered, I'm here him in their midst. God is here in our midst tonight. Daddy, we celebrate you. We celebrate your power. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. Luke 11 verse 20 says, but if it is by the finger of God that I cast out demon, then the kingdom of God has come upon you. The kingdom of God has come upon you. where you are right now is come upon your family. The kingdom of God has come upon you. The kingdom of God has come upon your difficult situation. The kingdom of God has come upon your negativity in the name of Jesus. Oh, Masata Bashadada. You're going to declare tonight, I'm way powerful than the devil himself. No devil from the pit of hell can stop me. No devil from the pit of hell can withstand me. Because what? The kingdom of God is coming upon me in the name of Jesus. Masato kasha da 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 da. Ekasoto basha da 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 da. The kingdom of God is coming upon us tonight, and I see God breaking shackles. Oh, shada basoto bashada da da. I see God breaking shackles, breaking chains in the name of Jesus. The moment we show up, the devil takes off. The moment we show up, the devil and the demons will take off. We are so powerful because the kingdom of God has come upon us. The kingdom of God has come upon our marriages, has come upon our children, has come upon our siblings, has come upon our parents in the name of Jesus. The kingdom of God has come upon us, and so shall it be in the name of Jesus. Amen. Matthew 22 verse 29 says, and Jesus replied, your mistake is that you don't know the scripture. I can't emphasize this a lot. He said, and you don't know the power of God. How can we actually flow in his grace if we don't actually know him? This is Jesus replying to the disciples. He says, that's the mistake we make. The mistake we make is that we don't actually know the word of God. We don't actually know the scripture. We have no idea what God can do. We just know God is powerful, but it's like we see God far away. We think he's so far off. No, there's power. In the name of Jesus, there's power in the kingdom of God. If God is saying to you tonight that my kingdom is coming upon you, then you receive it with all grace. You receive it with all grace. Things will never ever be the same in your life. In the name of Jesus, you're going to begin to declare, Father, I know you're powerful, and I have an encounter with your power tonight. In the name of Jesus. Oh, I just want you to be lost in the spirit right now. Begin to imagine what God can do. The one who created the heaven and the earth. The Most High God. The one who breathed his life into us. He created us in his own image. Is there anything too difficult for him to do? Is there any door he can't open? Is there any chain he can't break? Begin to imagine it tonight. God is all powerful. I believe in your power. I believe in your power, and I know I've got an encounter tonight. I know I'm so powerful. I know you've spoken your power upon my life tonight, and I will never ever remain the same in the name of Jesus. Amen. First Corinthians 4 verse 20 says, for the kingdom of God is not just a lot of talk. We Christians, we talk a lot. It's not just a lot of talk. It's living by God's power. You are a child of God. You've got to be aware that you are so empowered. No matter comes your way, you know the power of God is resting upon you. It's not just about talking about the situation. It's not just about talking. It's not just about praying a lot like. It's about you having this confidence that yes, I am a child of God and I'm so empowered. It's not about you just fearing stuff. You fear the devil, you fear anything that comes your way. No, you've got this assurance that God is with you. You've got this assurance that you're serving the King of all kings in the name of Jesus. So tonight you're going to declare, I receive the baptism. baptism of the power of God tonight. I so soak myself in the pool of His power tonight. This is my season to experience the power of God. This is my season to have a great encounter with the power of God in the name of Jesus. This is my season to experience His power in every dimension, in every area of my life, in the name of Jesus. The power of God is so resting on me tonight. The power of God is so resting on us tonight. You've got to declare it tonight. Oh, I will never walk out of your power in the name of Jesus. I will never ever walk out of your power. This is all I need. This is all I need to fulfill my purpose in life. This is all I need to be who you created me to be. This is all I need to soar high in life. This is all I need, Lord. I need your baptism tonight. I need you tonight. I need you to speak your power upon me, upon my life tonight, in the name of Jesus. Oh my God, this is an unforgettable experience. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. For in Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. You know what you're going to do tonight? You're going to speak the power of God over your family, wherever they might be tonight. Begin to speak the power of God. They have strong encounter with God tonight. Oh, shada, da, 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 da. Begin to speak the power of God over your family, over your parents. Speak the power of God over them. Speak the power of God over your siblings. Oh, masoto, bashada, da. Speak the power of God over your wives, over your husband. Begin to speak the power of God over your children tonight, over your career. Speak the power of God. Oh, masoto bashada, Daddy, I speak your power over my parents tonight in the name of Jesus. They encounter the greatness of your power. I speak your power over my siblings tonight in the name of Jesus. Oh, shadow dodo basata bashada, my nephews, you have encounter with God tonight. Oh, shadada. I speak your power. I speak your power over this ministry tonight. We encounter, we have fresh encounter with your power in the name of Jesus. Oh, masato bashada. My life is reflecting the power of God. I'm changed. I will never ever remain the same. My life has been transformed. Begin to declare where you are tonight. My life has been transformed, and so shall it be in the name of Jesus. Amen. So shall it be in the name of Jesus. Amen. I don't know your prayer, your heart desire. Maybe there's something you want to speak to God about tonight. You've been so moved tonight and you just want to pour your heart to God. You've been crying over this particular issue. And tonight you just want to pour your heart to God. I want you to begin to do so tonight. Father, if you don't help us, nobody would. If you don't support us over this issue, nobody would. Daddy, we need you tonight. I want to be stronger than my enemies. I'm so stronger than my enemies. Daddy, we need you tonight. Your people are pouring their heart to you tonight. Help them. Help them. Meet them at the very point of their needs. Oh, shadow do basa da 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 da. Baptize them with your power, oh Lord. They see their struggle no more. All they see is you. They see their disappointment no more. All they see is you. They see their shortcoming no more. All they see is you. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father, for in Jesus' mighty name we've prayed. Amen. I just, tonight is it's a sad night for me because I heard a sad news, you know. I just wanted to help me stand in gap for this particular person. I need healing. I want you to begin to join me tonight to begin to speak healing over this person. You might not know the person, but God knows the person. I want you to join me tonight to speak healing over her in the name of Jesus. Daddy, we need your healing. We need your healing in the name of Jesus. There's power in prayer. We speak your healing. We send your healing forth right now in the name of Jesus. Oh, shadow basata basha da 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 da. Let your healing power overshadow this person right now. Where she is now, Mother, we know there's nothing you can do. You're so powerful. You are ever powerful. And you've empowered us tonight. Daddy, we speak healing over this person. Thank you, mighty Jesus. For in Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. And so, Heavenly Father, we thank you for a release of your power upon your children tonight. We came together to seek power, and we know that you've so released your power upon us, and we receive the mantle right now to go everywhere to do good for your sake. In the name of Jesus, we receive the mantle right now to be your great representative here on earth. We receive the mantle right now to do everything we were created to do. We receive your mantle right now to fulfill our purpose in life. In the name of Jesus, this is our season, Lord. For in Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. If you believe it tonight, I want you to say a big amen in Jesus' name. You're so empowered. You're so empowered. I don't know if you can feel it tonight, but I so know it. And the Lord told me something tonight, that there's this particular person, the Lord says, is broken every chain. Every chain of failure in particular. The Lord is saying, is broken that chain tonight. In the name of Jesus, and him whom the Son has set free is so free indeed. So you are so free right now. Walk in the pool of his power in the name of Jesus. Amen. Thank you so much for tuning in tonight. God bless you. God bless you so much. I just want you to continue to pray, you know, for us to experience this, you know, unforgettable experience. This is the theme for this month. The Lord wants to baptize us with power. And suddenly, there's going to be a shift in our lives. In the name of Jesus. Please, don't ever slack in your prayers. No matter what is happening in your life, don't slack in your prayers. God wants to do something new in your life in the name of Jesus. Like I said, this month, we're not asking God, this 7 days, we're not asking for blessing or for anything. We're just asking for power, for transformation. And it's going to be an unforgettable experience in the name of Jesus. God bless you. I love you, but God loves you more. Go have a good evening, everyone. Good night, everyone. God bless you. Bye.